This video provides interview question for both fresh and working engineers. Analysis and design questions. Describe through sketch hyperstatic stresses in case of continuous pre-stress concrete girder. Explain Kern distances and procedure to calculate for given cross section. What are short term and long term pre-stress losses in post-tension member and procedure to compute these losses? Bridge design engineer should have strong fundamental knowledge of influence line diagram, as influence line diagram helps to find a maximum support reaction, shear force or bending moment. In this problem, please find out influence line diagram for reaction at support A, bending moment at support B and shear force at support C. As per Mueller-Breslow principle, for continuous beam to find influence line diagram for following, what shall be applied on a beam? Reaction at support, shear force at a section, bending moment at section. Please explain procedure through sketch. Understanding load path is a critical skill for a bridge engineer. Draw load path for following bowstring girder bridge when the deck is uniformly loaded. Describe two structural design criteria for design of cables in cable state bridges shown below. Describe critical live load position. Live load will be uniformly distributed load for cable marked A and B. Cable A is called backstay cable, stay cable. Sizing of a box girder is a first step in a bridge design. For single cell box girder, simply supported, shown in figure below, provide approximate range for span to depth ratio, L1 over L2 dimension and angle of web with horizontal theta. The gap between balance cantilever and cable state bridges is filled nowadays by extra dose bridges. They are aesthetic, cost effective and fast to build. Few questions on design of extra dose bridges. Describe structural design criteria for design of cables in extra dose bridge shown in figure below. Permissible stress in strain during service, height of pylon to main span ratio, initial sizing of a girder and pylon moment of inertia. Finally, question on construction. As for a design engineer, knowledge of how the bridge will be constructed and what will be different intermediate conditions through which the bridge will pass, as it will decide a design of a bridge. Describe various construction technology for large span bridge superstructure with sketches. Describe minimum 5 construction methods. Describe minimum 3 bridge element design where construction stage condition is governed instead final service condition. I hope you may have found this interview question interesting. You can drop your answer to my email address gourhemant@gmail.com or in the chat below.